opposition, sorry, for bringing up such valuable points that could be useful for our government's sustainable urban development bill. Firstly, I would like to note that this bill targets solely for residential purposes, because since it's a shelter bill, therefore all the measures that have been proposed will target solely on the residential side. That's just a point for clarification. Okay, firstly, the opposition member mentioned that the most updated version of the Building Control Act has been in place and it's also and has already put in place the increase of the green mark minimum criteria. What we believe that perhaps there might be some overlaps on the bill that we could amend in our shelter bill, but the opposition has raised a very valid point. But we would like to say that what we have increased the green mark minimum scheme to a specific number, which is 65, which means that in order to get a green mark certified rating, instead of the original 50 points, it's now increased to 65. So those who do not meet the requirements will not be able to get a green mark certified rating. And we believe that coming up with a more specific number will be better than just saying that there will be an increase in the green mark minimum criteria. Secondly, the opposition member has also mentioned that there have been financial incentives for these private developers to increase the need to target energy efficiency and water efficiency, for example, while building the residential properties. However, I'd like to state that for every assessment of the green mark criteria, an amount of money must be paid. For example, for residential buildings, it will be about 4,000 for a certain type of house. So what we propose is that these schemes be subsidized so that a mandatory assessment of all buildings in the long run of all buildings in Singapore the private developers will be able to afford to put the scheme in place. Also, the opposition member has mentioned regarding the increase of greenery in residential areas. I would like to clarify some points regarding that. Firstly, he said that the increase in planted balconies might not be feasible and you are unsure of whether where the planted balconies will be. In some condominiums in Singapore already, there have been planted balconies which are basically small balconies that extend up.
Order, I encourage the members in the opposition backbench to give Ms. Wang full attention. Thank you. Please continue, Ms. Wang.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. what planted balconies are is that they extend from the original building and they are safety, as in there have been such measures proposed. So we believe that this should be applied to all new residential buildings so as to increase the greenery and the aesthetics of the whole residential estate in general. Therefore, we believe that safety hazards will not be a concern. Yeah. Also, these kind of greenery, they can come in any form. They can come in potted, they can be fenced up. So, but the National Sustainable Urban Redevelopment Authority, they will make sure that all safety hazards will definitely be minimized, as we do not want these planted balconies and other greenery features to affect the residents in any way. Even in the building of say small scale gardens for existing buildings, we would definitely minimize the noise and noise inconvenience if there might be one. Secondly, mentioned about the management of the small scale gardens on the ground floor. This has been implemented in Singapore by the National Parks Board. The Community in Bloom program, also called the CIB project, has allowed many residents to come together to build these small-scale gardens around the land area. And it has been very successful in the sense that almost 300 gardens have been set up by the residents themselves. Therefore, we believe that if put on a larger scale, it will be more successfully implemented. Because, as seen from what has been done, it has been very successful. Lastly, I'd like to make mention that whatever schemes that we have proposed, there will definitely be some exceptions. exemptions. For example, we hope that all new buildings will be able to propose these. All new buildings will have to have these measures in place before the residents are allowed to inhabit these buildings. But for existing residential buildings, we understand there might be some concerns and considerations that must be made because not all buildings can have not all buildings will be able to increase their energy efficiency in the long run. Therefore, there will be exemptions to be made. Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Yeah.